Let's look at what the Holy Spirit can do for you and in you. Number one, Holy Spirit can be your helper. Write the coin down, can be what? Your helper. God wants every Christian, and I believe every human being, to engage in life, to prosecute life, to process life with the help of the Holy Spirit, because of the many challenges that life brings to a human being. So God the mastermind has arranged that every Christian must have the helper, the Holy Spirit. John 14:16 in the New King James is our anchor verse on that matter. Jesus is speaking. John 14:16. He says, I will ask the Father and he will give you another helper. Amen. That he may be with you forever. Look at the promise, how big and gigantic it is. He says, not just a helper, but someone who'll be with you forever. So that no matter what comes along in life, he's there with you. Write this thing down. The word helper in the Greek, it's parakletos. Parakletos. P-A-R-A-K-L-E-T-O-S. Parakletos. What does it mean? What does that mean? It means one called to be permanently alongside another. So that no matter what that other person faces, Paracletos produces solution.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's what we're missing. If we don't reach a level where we have that deep revelation about the Holy Spirit, we will be disadvantaged, children of God. Write this statement down. So according to what Jesus is saying in this particular word, scripture, Holy Spirit can help you and me to live the Christian life the correct way. Write these things down. He is here to help me. Who knows the Christian lifestyle? There's no school and college for it. The lecturer and the coach for the Christian life is the Holy Spirit. So he wants to be your helper. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Holy Spirit will help you to live your life. Write this point number two. Apart from helping you live the Christian life the correct way, he will help you live the Christian life in a way that glorifies God and in a way that blesses other people.
Is
your helper. Put in general terms, he comes to be your helper in all matters of this life. Say, oh Lord, may the Holy Spirit take charge of my life. Number two, we said Holy Spirit is your influencer. Put in other words, he is the producer of a godly character in you. Because without that godly character exhibited by you, you will not enter heaven. Heaven is not for corrupt and sinful Christians. So God has sent the Holy Spirit to help you in that regard. The anchor verse is Galatians 5:22-23 in the
Amplified.
He influences you. He influences you to produce a godly character. There it is on the wall, but the fruit of the Holy Spirit In brackets, the work which his presence within me and you accomplishes. So Holy Spirit can help you by working a work in you that will result in character and behavior change. A Christian has got no power to change himself or herself. But God deploys the Holy Spirit to come and do that work in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So write it down. Holy Spirit is the producer of the godly character in you. He helps you by producing the godly character in you. Amen.
Amen.
Say, go ahead, Holy Spirit. Welcome, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Welcome, Holy Spirit. I am in your presence. Anoint me with your power. I like the last part. Reign inside of me. Reign inside of me. Influence me. Control me. So that I produce godliness. And be a blessing to my God. And be a blessing to other people. Clap for the Holy Ghost. Number three. Are you writing, students? Holy Spirit can be your leader. In fact, he wants to be a leader or the leader of every Christian. Those who profess and claim to be children of God, the Bible says they must submit themselves to the daily leadership of the Holy Spirit. He can lead you. Write this statement down. Our anchor verse is Romans 8:14, please. Romans 8:14. It says, those who are led by the Spirit, that's what proves that these are children of God. Yes. So we need to be intentional. Say to yourself, and I must say to myself, now that I'm a child of God, Bible protocol demands that I be led by the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bible protocol dictates that I should be led by the Holy Spirit. Because if I'm not led by the Spirit, then I become a query child of God. Say query. query. Look at your name and say, be careful, you may be a query. So you allow the Holy Spirit to lead. Say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Like this, he can lead you to do all the good things God wants you to do in your lifetime. Write it down. Holy Spirit can lead you. He's ready to lead you. To do all the good things that God wants you to do in your lifetime. Put simpler. He wants to help you or lead you towards fulfilling your destiny. That one you must write. That one is a serious one. Because it's connected to that Matthew 7:21. Holy Spirit wants to lead you towards fulfilling your destiny. The Bible says no one knows what God has prepared for us. But he reveals these things to us by the Holy Spirit. Lift up your hand and say, Holy Spirit, lead me towards fulfilling my destiny. May I live my life fulfilling what I was born for. I feel something. This is big. May I live my life fulfilling what I was born for. Holy Spirit. This is serious. our example is Jesus himself.
Matthew 4 verse 1.
He was led by the Holy Spirit to go and prepare for his ministry in a special way. Look at Jesus. You know, when I read verses like this, I feel so ashamed that if Jesus could submit himself to be led by the Spirit, who is justice to think I will make it, I can make it? Jesus was led by the Holy Spirit to
me.
Have you seen that example? It's on the wall.
Yes.
Listen to what Isaiah says about being led by God. Isaiah 48:17. In the New Living Translation. Oh my God. My God. Let's read the New Living Translation. 1, 2, 3, go. 1, 2, 3, go. Everyone.
That's what I'm saying again.
This is what the Lord says.
Who is saying? Hello. Let me. Apostle Justice.
The Lord.
So why are you behaving like this? This is God speaking to you. This is what the Lord is what says. Your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Who's the Redeemer of the Christians?
God.
What is he saying? 1, 2, 3, go. I am the Lord your God who teaches you what is good for you and leads you along the path you should follow. Not opinions of people. God's master plan for your life. What is to be led by the Holy Spirit? What does it mean to be led by the Holy Spirit? Write it down. Please write down. Why do you write? This is like your scaftin. In the course of the week, you'll open this scaftin to see what did God say on Sunday, which may help me in this problem I'm facing now. Please, Pastor, let's mature. Respond well to the word of God. To be led by the Holy Spirit is to be prompted by him. Write it down. Prompted. It means all of a sudden something prompts me or moves me to do something. To be led by the Holy Spirit is to be instructed by him and to be directed by him. So it's a threefold exercise. Prompted, instructed, directed. Prompted, instructed, directed. So it means I'm supposed to do something. Or maybe I'm not ready to do anything. Something prompts me to pray. After prayer, I discover, oh, I was praying because of this accident. It would be my car if I didn't pray.
Ngabe imoto yami kuba ngathandazi.
Number 4.
Kwesine.
Holy Spirit wants to be your guide.
I'm moving
my day. He wants to be what? Your guide.
Ufuna kuba ngumcondisi.
Anchor verses John 16:13.
Li verse lelisekela lokhu.
Listen to how I'm putting it for your benefit. He wants to be your guide. One who guides you. What guide you into what? Write this one down, is powerful. Guide you into taking the right actions. Making the right decision. That will not put you into trouble or hurt other people. The Holy Spirit wants to guide you into making right decisions, taking right action, so that you don't plunge yourself into troubles by making wrong decisions and acting in a way that will cost you your job or do things that will cause your business to fail.
No matter when the thing let out in the business,
he wants to guide you.
Ufuna kukuqondisa.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that through that guided life, write it down, you live a safe and preserved life. A life that avoids plunging into troubles. A life that avoids committing costly blunders. Hey, this is serious. Let's look at this verse. It changed my life. Holy Spirit will help you to make decisions and take actions and do things that will lead to your overall fruitfulness, which will result in you living a fulfilled life. Am I helping somebody? Is this too complicated? Acts 16 verse number 6. Look at what happened to Paul. This one, it shocked me. The example of being guided, also combined with being led. We read it in the New Living Translation. Let's read it together. 1, 2, 3, go. Next, Paul and Silas traveled through the area of Phrygia and Galatia because the Holy Spirit, look at it, they traveled through to the area of Phrygia and Galatia because the Holy Spirit had prevented them from preaching the word in the province of Asia. They wanted to go to another city in Asia because they submitted themselves to be guided by the Holy Spirit. Just when their beds were ready, they are going. Holy Spirit said, no, guys, unpack your bags. Look at the following 1:7. This one is my favorite. Oh my God. Then coming to the borders of Mysia, they headed north to the province of Bithynia. But again, Lakusta kipasia makata. How many now? Boma fushuku kya shukaj. So sainile, so ungenile, so hambile. Hey!
Jesus.
Yeah. Lo thanda zakabanga udlala esithombe selutsaka lolubhuqile tinto lotifake kuto wayifaka nemali yahamba nemtilane mfula waseSwatini kosiya oh my God. Such guidances, Bazalwane, of the Holy Spirit can save us from all the troubles and problems we put ourselves in. The troubles, the problems. Yebo. How many girls today have got babies they never wanted to have? But yakuvala tindlebe kuboya ingcwele. Why akusan boy? Kan vele ngisan boy utakusan boya.
Jesus.
Open your mouth and pray. Can you imagine? Can you imagine the decisions, the wrong decisions we make? Today we've got babies that are raised by girls. Their fathers are nowhere to be found. The real names of those babies.
If I listen.
Spiwa ingos for what? Nika lo mntwana ligama lakhe lelikhari lelicorrect. Mhla pray. Pray. Especially the girls, if you are blessed, you have not yet been impregnated.
Now
by a boy who run away. Keep your panty tight.
Dikine.
Amen.
Did you hear what I've said? Keep that panty tight.
Fuck it,
my tights in a tool. Fuck it in a tool. Let's fuck and band. 4 layers.
Figwa.
Hallelujah.
Four layers. Am I talking to somebody in the house today? Lipro hashanda kapastalaya. Let's allow the Holy Spirit to guide us. If you don't put the four layers, open your mouth and pray. Thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus. Say thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Say Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
I submit myself
to your guidance.
Guide me.
Lead me.
Now and forever. Let me end it here. Rise. Enough for today. Yeah. We are there. Lift up your right hand. Before you lift up your right hand, let's do a revision. Number one, we said Holy Spirit can do what? One. Hold your notes in here. I'm running a big school here. I'm running a serious training here. Number one, Holy Spirit can do what? I didn't hear you. Holy Spirit can do what? Even those following us on television, Holy Spirit can do what? Lead you. He wants to lead you. So that you live your life what? The correct way. Number two, Holy Spirit wants to do what? Huh? Oh, number one, I said what? Oh, I said helper. Oh, so Holy Spirit wants to do what? To help you in what? In all matters of life. Pray, say, Holy Spirit, help me. May I surrender myself to the help you are ready to give me. In the name of Jesus. Say, Holy Spirit, I submit to your help. Be my helper. Number two. Holy Spirit wants to be what? Your influencer. Huh? Your what? What was the anchor verse?
Galatians 5:22.
Amen. We read it in the Amplified. It says, this is what Holy Spirit is going to produce in the life of a Christian. Sase Nyashu, I made a statement, never forget it. Holy Spirit wants to produce in you the godly character that is needed for you to make it to heaven.
Amen.
Huh? Number three. He wants to do what? To lead you, to be your leader. What was the anchor verse?
Romans 8:14.
Those that are led by who? By the Holy Spirit. They are what? They are children of God. And we made an example about Jesus who was what? Was led by the Holy Spirit. Here is a statement. If Jesus was led by the Holy Spirit, how can you not be led by the Holy Spirit? If Jesus is your captain. Number four. Holy Spirit wants to do what?
To be my guide.
He wants to guide you. In what? Anchor verses, John 16:13. Let's read the verse 1, 2, 3, go.
When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all truth.
Full stop. He will do what?
Guide you.
Ufuna kukuhola.
Amen.
Lift up your hand. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Fill my life, Lord, with your presence. You are welcome.
You are welcome.
My life, you are welcome.
You
open your mouth and pray.
These are the things I want you to pray. I'll give them to you four of them. Never forget them. We are going to drill and repeat these things until people get a deep, compelling revelation. I want to see Christians of this church crying for the Holy Spirit. Because that is what will result in us becoming powerful human beings. These are the four things you pray. Number one, you say, Holy Spirit, please lead me today. Open your mouth. The Holy Spirit, please lead me today. So when you pray in the morning before you go out, Holy Spirit, please lead me today. Please lead me today. Pray. Holy Spirit, please lead me. Lead me to the will of God. Holy Spirit, direct me to the will of God. Lead me, Holy Spirit. Lead me, Holy Spirit. Number two, Holy Spirit, please guide me. Help me to make the right decisions. Help me to take the right actions. Holy Spirit, please guide me. Holy Spirit, guide me. Lead me towards making the right decisions. Just as you guided Paul, guide me. Sense of God, pray like you are praying. There are decisions you are going to be making this week. There are people who are going to come and suggest things, ideas to you. They will tell you, Yemgam, let's do ABC. Holy Spirit must guide you there. Because if not, you may come back 6 months down the line. Crying, having lost serious money, serious opportunities. Talk to him now. Nandoka, Pastor Laya. And mention the things you need to do and say, Holy Spirit, guide me. I'm supposed to do ABC, guide me. I'm supposed to start business, ABC, guide me. I'm supposed to pursue, you know, academic career, ABC, guide me, lead me. Help me, cry out, help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, help me. Talk to him. Lembro kapazata kapaza. Yela makayanda kamaza. Help me, Holy Spirit. Help me, Spirit of the Living God. Help us, Holy Ghost. Help us. May we submit ourselves to the help you are ready to give. Lemruka pazata. Pray. Saints of God, pray. I'm helping you. You know, if Holy Spirit can guide you, can come out of those troubles that are troubling. Ask him now. Tell him, Holy Spirit, I'm in a situation ABC. Please help me, helper of heaven. Help me, Holy Spirit. Lambruka pazata. Help me, Holy Spirit. Zendala makatabaya. Help me, Holy Spirit. Look at me, please. We are praying now. Young people, lift up your hands. Holy Spirit must help you to produce A grades. Are you hearing me? Pray as young people. Because your key out of poverty and lack of money and begging for money is academia, my young ones. I'm telling you. If you don't help yourself to be educated very well, what you will live a life of a beggar till you die. Pray. Holy Spirit must help us. Pray. Limbro hashanda kamasa. Young ones, I'm supposed to hear your voice crying to say to God, Holy Spirit, help me to be an A student. I don't want to be a beggar when I'm old. Oh my God. Zantala basaka bayanta masaka. Zipuranda kimasaya makata. Zetala basaka babayanda. Ela babazaka. As a young person, your gateway out of poverty and begging for money is to get yourself well educated. Academia has the way to go. If you fail there, chances are you'll live a life of a beggar for money. Zantolanda kopasata basakabaya. Limbru hashanda kamasaya. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we worship you. La prakapazata. Take this last point. Every day, ask Holy Spirit to fill you with wisdom.
And anoint you with power for conquering evil. So that even if at work there's someone who uses muti, that muti will bounce by reason of the anointing. Oh, I feel it. Why do you think some of us are still standing? That muti will bounce by reason of the anointing. Lift up your hands and pray. That muti will bounce by reason of the anointing. Praise somebody. That bewitchment will bounce. Lembruka pazata. Pray. The anointing will enter a boardroom and fight for you when they are gossiping you to the bosses to put you in trouble. Ask for the Holy Ghost to anoint you with power. Lead me, Holy Spirit. Guide me, Holy Spirit. Oh my God. Fill me with wisdom, Holy Spirit. Anoint me with your power. Day after day as I go to work. That's powerful. That's the clothing of a Christian. Ulama katabayanda. The packaging for successful living. Lendo kasalinda masa. Oshapa katabaya. Alabasaya. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord bless you.
Amen.
The Lord cause his face to shine upon you.
Amen.
I commit you to God. May you be devoted to God. May you never be a person who takes God for granted. But may you be one who worships God, who honors God. May you be a person who is good to other people. I commit you to the word of today. Let this word change you into another person. May you live a life that will amaze your relatives. A life that will amaze your friends. A life that will cause you, my God, to be different from everybody. A life that will cause you to rise and conquer every problem. By the word of today, may you rise and become a new champion. A new champion in your family. A celebrity. A respected one at your workplace. May the word of today cause you to distinguish yourself like Daniel. Outshine your peers. I say outshine your peers. I say outshine your peers. May you be a darling of your bosses because of the way you perform by Holy Ghost power. Oh my God. Pray. May you be delivered from the life of confusion. By the Holy Spirit, may you come out of every confusion. Can you say amen? I say by the Holy Spirit, come out of every confusion. I say by the Holy Spirit, come out of all disappointments. I say by the Holy Spirit, come out of every failure. I say by the Holy Spirit, begin to break through into amazing opportunities because you will allow him to lead you. He will lead you to greener pastures. I pray that the Holy Spirit would lead you to greener pastures. May doors of greener pastures open for you. Pray. Lepro hashanda. Lambra kapaza. Lembra kapazata. Alinda kamase. Jela basaya.